Hello friends, today I am going to deal with further part of study of binary equilibrium diagrams. I am P.P. Mitragutri from Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur. I am assistant associate professor at Mechanical Engineering Department. So at the end of this session, students will be able to analyze solidification behavior of various compositions in the alloy system, as well as they will be able to interpret the significance of various transformations taking place in binary alloy systems. So, in the earlier session, we have discussed equilibrium diagram for isomorphous system. Isomorphous system is one in which all the compositions often in such alloy system are completely mutually soluble in each other in liquid state as well as in solid state. Today we are going to study another equilibrium diagram, that is equilibrium diagram for the system exhibiting partial solubility or partial solubility in solid state. In such system, all the alloys will not be solid solution alloys, but some of the alloys will be non-solid solution alloys, unlike in isomorphous system of alloys. Now, to construct equilibrium diagram of such type, we need to have some data. So let us assume the two metals A and B. Let MP of A be 1000 degrees Celsius, and let MP of B be 800 degrees Celsius. Let B is soluble in A up to 8% at 766 degrees Celsius, and let B is soluble in A up to 2% at 0 degrees Celsius. Similarly, let A be soluble in B up to 4.5% at 766 degrees Celsius, and let A be soluble in B up to 1.5% at 0 degrees Celsius. And in such system, there will be one eutectic point, and eutectic will occur at 766 degrees Celsius and at 46% of B. So with this data, we will construct the equilibrium diagram exhibiting partial solid solubility. This diagram will be like this. Percentage B will be on x-axis, temperature will be on y-axis. Let us mark 1000 degree melting point of A and 800 degrees melting point of B at extreme ends. Then at one end there will be 100% A, at another end there will be 100% B. I will mark 0.46% B. Then the diagram will be like this. A, B, C will be liquidus line. A, D, B, E, C will be solidus line. Now in this case, above liquidus line, there will be liquid phase. In between this region, there will be solid solution alpha, which is nothing but it is solid solution of solute B in solvent A, while On other end, there will be solid solution beta, which is solid solution of solute A in solvent B. Then in this region, there will be liquid plus alpha. In this region, there will be liquid plus beta. In this region, there will be alpha plus eutectic. While in this region, there will be beta plus eutectic. This temperature is 766 degrees Celsius. This line is solidus line. Line DF and EG are solvus lines, which indicate lines of limiting solubility in solid state. Now, in this case, there are three types of alloys. Alloys, before that, I will mark the percentages over here. So, in this case, if you look to this diagram, we will see that there is group 1 alloys. In group 1 alloys are the alloys which contain up to 2% B and more than 98.5% B. These alloys solidify as solid solution and retain their solid solution structure even at room temperature. This is group 1 alloys. Another group of alloys is alloys which solidify as solid solution but are unable to retain solid solution structure at room temperature. These are the alloys containing more than 2% B and up to 8% B and more than 95.5% of B and up to 98.5% of B. These are group 2 alloys. While group 3 alloys are the alloys which contain more than 8% B and up to 95.5% B. These are group 3 alloys. All these group 3 alloys are non-solid solution alloys. In that there are three types. One is hypoeutectic. Hypoeutectic alloys are the alloys containing more than 8% B and up to 46% B. While hyper-eutectic alloys are the alloys which contain more than 46% B and up to 95.5% B. While eutectic alloy is one which contain 46% B. Now in this case, if we consider alloy is having up to 2% B and more than 98.5% B can be hot worked as well as cold worked. But alloys containing more than 2% B and up to 8% B cannot be cold worked, but by heating them above solvus line, we can hot work them very easily. And group 3 alloys are non-solid solution alloys. They have fixed solidus temperature and variable liquidus temperature, and their liquidus temperature is much lower than group 1 and group 2 alloys, so they have lower freezing range, and such alloys can only be cast. They have excellent casting properties. They can neither be forged nor be rolled nor be extruded. And with this, I conclude study of equilibrium diagram having partial solution. So references for this study are Material Science and Metallurgy by Dr. V.D. Kodgire and Introduction to Engineering Materials by B.K. Agarwal. Thank you once again.